I'm hoping I will be able to get back with... Oh, crap, I'm stuck. No, no, no. Oh, no, 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 no. Not now. Hello gamers, I'm Bartwari and welcome back to another episode of Conan Exiles. And today, well, today I would like to start building our, what's it going to be, our medieval city, castle, stronghold thingy. And I kind of already placed first stones, but I'm not quite sure if I will keep them like that. I wanted to have the entrance running parallel to the entrance up there. But yeah, I think that won't be... won't be working at all, so I will have to change a few things. Yeah, maybe put up the entrance a little bit more in this direction. So I will have to play around with that. I'm not quite sure how I'm gonna do it. But anyway, I'm gonna be building, collecting materials in order to be able to build. But I would also like to head inside the sunken city. Well, the sunken city. What am I talking about? The Thrall City, of course. And go grab some trolls. But first of all, I think I will be placing a Wheel of Pain. We don't have a Wheel of Pain yet. And I think we should by now have all the materials to build one. Let me have a look up top. I should have 60... Oh no, not this. Where is the... Ah, here it is. 60 of these should be no problem. I need 200 of these. Iron reinforcements, yes. And I need 60 bricks as well. I remember something about bricks. So I'll be grabbing a stack of bricks. And what else do I need? Well, I need... oh, I have everything. Nice. I will be needing gruel as well. But I think, yeah, that will be for later on. Meanwhile, I'm going to be repairing all my armor since we now have some steel, which is awesome. There you go. Everything ready, everything built. Oh, and again, the level as well. Let me put some stuff back in here. And I don't need these, so I will be putting those back into the box. The metal, the rest I will be keeping. I'm not quite sure if I need all the bone, but I will be... putting some snacks in this box for later use. You never know, it might come in handy. The hide I can safely put in here. I don't need all that hide. And I can put those things shaped woods back in here as well. I'm starving. I am starving. I'm gonna die. No. I have some purified flesh, which is amazing. Okay. Put down the Wheel of Pain. Let's see, where will be put the Wheel of Pain? This is overlapping with another object or terrain. Same here. Oh, it allows me to put it up there, so I will be doing that for now. Yeah. There, a Wheel of Pain. I should have some fiber somewhere. Maybe there is even some gruel in this box already. No. Fiber, and this is something I will be able to use. So I'm going to be putting all that into the... crap, I need to get out. Into the bonfire. This should allow me to make some gruel, which we can then use to tame some trolls. And yeah, I think I'm going to be heading inside the... Thrall City and try to find myself some trolls to tame. While I'm building, I can have the trolls taming up, so why not? What am I missing? I'm probably missing more fiber. Yeah, let me go grab some more fiber, have some gruel running, and then I will meet you guys back to take a little trip into the Thrall City and maybe find some interesting trolls to tame. So I'll talk to you guys once I have everything set up and ready. Okay, back with a little update. I have some furnaces running, but while collecting some metal, I noticed that there is already a Wheel of Pain up here, which means we can now break the will of about, I think, eight trolls at the same time if you want to. So I'm gonna go hit these rocks of metal, iron, I should say, and bring that back to base, turn on another furnace, and then I will be heading into the Thrall City and try to find some stuff to tame. So let me bring that back to the base really quick. All the metals I'm collecting, all the materials I'm collecting actually, will be used for building purposes. We will be building out of tier 2 materials to start with. And those require a lot of stuff, and really a lot of stuff. I checked a few things. We need plenty of bricks. We need plenty of iron reinforcements. And we need a lot of those, wooden thing-shaped wood as well. So, yeah, but first things first, let's have a look inside the... What's happening? Oh, I thought I couldn't run anymore. Let's go make a little trip into the Thrall City and see if we can find something to bring back to our base and maybe to break its will. So let me head in there and I will keep you guys updated when I have found something interesting. I need wood to repair my shield, so let's quickly grab some, head back out, repair my shield, and then I should be ready for some things. Oh, what's this? This is a performer. I'm gonna grab it. It's a, what's it called? It's the Seth one, I think. The Seth High Priest. Nice. Oh crap. A snake. Did he call the snake? Oh, venom. Oh, nice. I didn't see that. Okay, let's first bring this guy back before we lose him again. Yeah, I got him on the rope. So run, baby, run. And bring that one to our Wheel of Pain so we can start breaking its will. And then I can come back and grab a few more. Because, yeah, I have room for 4, so... Why not? Why not go grab a few more while I'm here anyway? Oh, I thought I lost him. Good. Still have him? Nice. Can I run to the other Wheel of Pain, maybe? I'm out of stamina. No, I'm not. So, running to the Wheel of Pain, which is in the back, since that has plenty of gruel already, and I should be able to reach it, I think. Yeah, it looks like that. Okay, put the High Priest of Seth into the Wheel of Pain. That's a good start. I think that's actually the really high level one. I'm not sure. Turn on this one. I'm not sure because there is also an Archpriest. I have that shield. They are ripping through my shield like through butter. This will be tough. Okay, I'm heading back to the Thrall City and I will be trying to find myself a blacksmith, carpenter and a smelter as well. So yeah, let me do that and I will bring you guys back once I have an update. I'm gonna check this area. I haven't been that far yet, so I need to be careful. I don't want to get jumped by 10 Thralls at the same time, so... Oh, look at the metal deposits up here. I don't see anything interesting yet. Yeah, let's check this area. Oh, look, there is something up there. Or someone up there, actually. There are two guys. Oh, this is a blacksmith. I want that one. He will keep staying there or what? Yeah, come. I'm gonna go grab the blacksmith. Level 2 blacksmith, nice. I want it. Definitely want it. Come on. And you, what are you? Fighter? Are you a fighter? I didn't see. Knock you down. I don't know what you are. Armorer? Ooh, nice. So this is a I need to bring that one down first, I think. Armorer, and this is the blacksmith. Yeah, blacksmith, you're mine. Oh, hurry, hurry, hurry back to my base. Oh, let's hope I can make it. Wait, it's this way, right? Yeah. I'm going to be jumping off some cliffs. Will be a lot faster than... big cliff. Can I jump down? I don't want to get killed. I can jump down. Nice. Ah, now I'm out of stamina. Well, once I have the blacksmith back at base, I think I'll have enough for now. It's a blacksmith level 2, which is pretty darn good. It's a good start. From things I have learned already is that the higher level thralls improve the crafting speed of the thing you put them in. So if I put a level 1 blacksmith into a blacksmith, it will produce faster than without a thrall. A level 2 one will produce even faster than the level 1 one. And I have to do for some further testing, but I also have the impression that they use less fuel. I could be completely wrong, but I have the impression that the higher tier thralls use less fuel to make stuff than the lower tier ones. Yeah, we'll have to do some more testing on that. Well, I should actually try to fill up this wheel of pain, actually. Yeah, might be a good idea. Okay, I'm going to make a few more trips to the Thrall City, try to fill up our wheel of pains. And I will get back to you guys once I have an update and we can start doing some building. Okay, guys, look what I knocked down. A level 3 smelter, a tier 3 smelter. So quickly bringing that one back. I found another carpenter and blacksmith as well. But once I noticed the level 3 smelter, I thought, oh, let's quickly bring that one back to base. So yeah, I'm running back. I'm hoping I will be able to get back with... Oh, crap, I'm stuck. No. No. Not now. Ah, crap, almost. Maybe this way? No. Oh, why does it always happen? Okay, let's concentrate. Sprint. Yes, I got it. Oh, no, I didn't. I finally got out. Nice. I don't think I will be risking bringing it to the back, the back one. I will be trying to put it into the first Wheel of Pain, because, yeah, I don't want to lose it. Although I could maybe still make it. If I sprint to the end, it might work. And if not, then I would have lost a nice one. Fingers crossed. Last one for the Wheel of Pain at the end, I think. Yeah, definitely the last one. Oh, I'm gonna make it. Yes. So, a level 3 smelter, a carpenter, level 2 blacksmith, and a Seth High Priest. I don't think I can put any more in there, but I'm gonna be venturing inside a few more times, maybe fill up the other Wheel of Pain as well. And yeah, then we will be ready for some building. Okay, I promised I would be doing some building as well. And yeah, we will be starting with the first thing for our medieval castle, which is, what we call the gatehouse. It's like a small building in front of the castle. Well, it's a stronghold, a medieval stronghold. And at the front, there is normally a dual gate building, which can be used to filter out people coming in into the castle and people getting out. So normally it's a rectangular thing with two big gates and towers on the side. So I will be putting that up here. It will be reasonably big, I think. So I think I will be building it in that direction, which means I should be placing my stones somewhere up there. I don't want to place them too close to the floor. Because yeah, for some reason I think maybe things will be a little bit higher further up, and I don't really want to mess around with that. So place the first block. Let's place it somewhere up here. Something like this. This will be the first block. So that's going to be normally the area which will hold the gate. And if I checked it correctly, the gate will be centered on those blocks. Let me show you. Yes, I can do it like that. Normally I need three blocks. What? Ah, there you go. So you see, that's the gate. Come on, give it to me. There, the gate. So that's fine. And starting from there, I can build the towers. Now, I could build square towers, but I've been thinking, why not play around with these? The rectangular things. And normally, if I would place a rectangle, then a square, then a rectangle, then a square, then a rectangle, square, rectangle, square, I should end up with something which looks a little bit rounded. So let's try that. Yep, there we go. And I should normally arrive back where I started. One more square. No, that's... Yeah, the square can go there. And one more rectangle. Yeah. Oh, no. This one. Okay, I will need to fill this up probably with rectangles. That should work. And I will be making the same on this side. So... Squares, rectangle, no, triangles, of course. Triangles, square, triangles, square, triangles, square, triangle, square, and one more square and one more triangle should do the trick. Oh, thirsty. Okay, let's fix that. Okay, so this will be the gate. These will be two round towers. And now we can continue our build in that direction. I think I will be missing foundations, so I will have to make some more of these. And yeah, get back to you guys once I have more stuff ready for you to see. Okay, I have some more foundations, so let's continue. 4, 5, 6. Let's have a look how... That looks 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Maybe add one more on every side and start building our towers again from here. But yeah, as you can clearly see, I don't have enough materials. I definitely don't have enough materials to build everything, so I will have to wait a little bit and yeah, until my carpenter has made some more shaped wood, and then I can come back and show you guys what I have in mind. Okay, back, and I think I should have enough stuff to finish the outsides of this area. Let me check. 5. Yes, that's enough. And now I should be able to fill up the... Oh, crap. Oh, crap. Not two times. Demolish this one. Demolish... I wish they made a little plugin or litter. How should I call it? Mod, which allows you to pick up everything. Because... Fail to place building. Okay, fail to place building. There is no reason why it fails. The fix, use your scroll wheel a few times, blah, 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 And now it will be placing. You see? Placed perfectly this time. So what else do I have to do? That is fill up the gaps, which means I need a few more rectangular things. And yeah, I will be filling this up. I will probably be doing this off camera because we've been busy so long on getting the thralls that, yeah, I didn't have enough time to build stuff anymore. Let me check. Do I have some more? No, I cannot make any more because I'm missing the shaped wood. But yeah, I think this will be it for today. I'm going to be wrapping up today's episode right here. Yeah, this probably doesn't show you really what I have in mind for the entrance, the, how is it called, the gatehouse. But this should be a big gate in the front, big gate in the back, towers at the four corners, and yeah, at least four blocks high. I'm thinking about building it even higher than that, because the gate is already four blocks high, and I want to have a little balcony for archers shooting down from the top towards the entrance of the gate as well. Now, how will this continue? Well, from here on, we will be making a large outer wall, which will stretch, well, we don't know yet. Probably up till here, then probably from here up till there, to the end. Make the tour, head back in that direction, up, and then come back to the front gate. We might even expand it even further to the back, not quite sure. We will see how things go, how much materials we can get, and yeah, we will see. I don't know yet. But anyway, I think I will be wrapping up today's episode. I know this building didn't end as well as I had expected. You will have to bear with me until we place some walls, and only when we have placed walls and gates, then it will be becoming clear what we want to do with this building. But I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, feel free to hit the thumbs up button, and if you have comments or suggestions, you can post those in the comment section below the video. While you are there, feel free to hit the subscribe button. Not only do you help me reach my next subscriber goal, but you will also get notified when I post new content to the channel. Also, check the description, that's where you find links to my social media pages, links to our Patreon page, and links to the other crazy folks and creative misfits guys as well. Well, I think I'm gonna be wrapping up today's episode. Until next time, have fun and stay safe. Bye!